So hello everyone, myself Dr. Swati. In this video, I would like to explain about aldol and cross-aldol condensation. This is one of the important named reaction of carbonyl compounds. So it is a part of unit 4 in pharmaceutical organic chemistry 1, which is a part of B-Pharmacy second semester course. So now let us proceed with this aldol and cross-aldol condensation, which is specific for the carbonyl compound. So what are carbonyl compounds? The organic compounds containing carbonyl group means C double bond O group are known as carbonyl compounds. So aldehydes and ketones are the examples for the two different classes of carbonyl compounds. So there are various reactions which are mentioned for these carbonyl compounds, like nucleophilic addition reactions. Carbonyl compounds will undergo, and in addition to nucleophilic addition reactions, they will also undergo oxidation reactions and reduction reactions. But the speciality of these carbonyl compounds is, in addition to the mentioned reactions, they will undergo self-condensation reactions. That means one aldehyde with another aldehyde, or one ketone with another ketone, or one aldehyde with another ketone, they can undergo self-condensation and gives new products. Okay, so that is the speciality of these carbonyl compounds, and one such reaction I am going to discuss now. So that is called aldol condensation. Let us now first see the definition of aldol condensation. So it is the condensation of two or more aldehydes or ketones, or even one aldehyde with one ketone which is having alpha hydrogen, and they undergo condensation in the presence of strong alkali. Okay, and they finally produce a product called aldol. Okay, so what is this aldol? Aldol is nothing but it is a beta hydroxy aldehyde or beta hydroxy ketone, that is known as aldol. Okay, so what is happening? Carbonyl compounds are undergoing condensation. Okay, and finally giving aldol as the product. So the reaction is known as aldol condensation. Okay, so what is the prerequisite? What type of carbonyl compounds will undergo this aldol condensation? Means the compound which is going to undergo aldol condensation must have alpha hydrogen. So this is one of the prerequisite for any carbonyl compound to undergo aldol condensation. And here we mentioned in the definitions that the reaction will be happening in the presence of alkali. So what type of alkali we can use? That is, alkalis like sodium hydroxide, barium hydroxide and potassium carbonate we can use in order to perform aldol condensation. So as I mentioned earlier, aldol will be the product in aldol condensation. The resulting aldol, it is a beta hydroxy compound. That means it is more or less like an alcoholic compound. So alcohols having ability to undergo even dehydration reaction. So the resulting aldol will undergo dehydration, and it gives corresponding alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde or ketone. Now let us see few examples for this aldol condensation. So here I am giving two important examples. So first reaction, it is an aldol condensation between two moles of acetaldehyde. Okay, and this two will undergo condensation in the presence of sodium hydroxide. So what is happening here? CH3CHO is one molecule, and this is another molecule of acetaldehyde. So we need to just in a condensation reaction link the two molecules. So how? Here from CH3CHO, the CH2 side of the molecule will go and attach to the carbonyl carbon of the another acetaldehyde. So you can see here CH3CHOH. So this part is coming from first mole of the acetaldehyde. So O is becoming OH here, and from the second mole of acetaldehyde, we need to remove one hydrogen. So how it is going to happen, we'll see in the reaction mechanism. So then it will become CH2CHO, and this will link to the carbonyl carbon of first mole of the acetaldehyde. So that is how we get aldol. You can see here aldol means it is beta hydroxy aldehyde. So this is called alpha carbon, and this is called beta carbon. Okay, alpha means the carbon which is adjacent to the functional group is called alpha carbon. Okay, so this is beta hydroxy aldehyde, that is corresponding aldol we get here, which upon dehydration, so in dehydration what happens, from one carbon hydrogen and from the adjacent carbon hydroxyl group will be removed in the form of water. So from where the groups are removed, their double bond will be introduced, so we get alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde. And similarly, we can see one more reaction. So here, the second example is a aldol condensation between 2 moles of acetone. Okay, this is acetone. Undergo condensation in the presence of again base, that is sodium hydroxide. And here we get corresponding aldol. So you can see the difference here. When two aldehydes are undergoing condensation, here the resulting aldol is having, it is a beta hydroxy aldehyde. Okay. When two ketones are undergoing aldol condensation, here we get the product as aldol, which is a again beta hydroxy ketone it is. So here also you can see CH3COCH3. This has been written like this, CH3COCH3. Okay, so this part we are getting from the first mole of acetone, and this CH3 will become CH2 in the mechanism. So this will become now CH2 minus COCH3, and that will be attached. This is the second mole of acetone, which is attached to the first mole of acetone, carbonyl carbon. So that is how we get aldol. This also upon dehydration, we get finally corresponding alpha beta unsaturated ketone. Now let us see briefly the mechanism involved in the aldol condensation. So you can see here there are three steps involved in its mechanism. So what are they? The first step is known as enolate ion, which is nothing but a nucleophile. Okay. And the second step, the formed nucleophile, that is enolate ion, will be attacking to the carbonyl group to form the aldol. And in the third step, dehydration will happen for the resulting aldol to give corresponding alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound. Now let us see this mechanism with the help of the first example, that is in between 2 moles of acetaldehyde we get corresponding alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde. Okay, so the first step is formation of enolate ion. So you can see here we have taken acetaldehyde molecule. So this is base. From where we are getting this OH minus is hydroxyl ions will be acting as base, which is obtained from the sodium hydroxide, which we are taking as the alkaline medium in this reaction. So the function of base is always to abstract the proton. So which kind of proton? Always alpha protons, alpha hydrogens are acidic in nature. So this base will try to abstract the alpha hydrogen from the acetaldehyde. Then what happens? This OH minus and this H plus will make water molecule. So water will be formed as byproduct here. And what happens to the rest of the molecule? Now this pair of electrons, okay, this bonded pair of electrons will be retained on carbon only. Okay, then this will make CH2 minus CHO, and this is called enolate ion. Okay, so it is a nucleophile. Enolate ion is a nucleophile. So now this will act as nucleophile, and this will try to attack on the carbonyl carbon of what? Of the second acetaldehyde molecule. So the same is shown here. This is CH2 which is acting as nucleophile, and it attacks on the carbonyl carbon, because always carbonyl carbon is electropositive. Okay. So what happens here in the next step? The CH2CHO, that is enolate ion, will be attaches to the carbonyl carbon of acetaldehyde. When it attaches to the carbonyl carbon becomes pentavalent. So in order to attain the stability, immediately the pi bond will migrate onto oxygen in the form of O minus. Okay, just we are linking the CH3CH, O. O is becoming O minus after taking the pi pair of electrons, and we are linking this enolate ion to the carbonyl carbon. So we get corresponding anion. Now in the first step, if you see, there is formation of water. Now from water, protons will be taken up. So that is what is shown here. So protons will be taken up by O minus, so that they will convert to give corresponding aldol. Okay. So this is alpha carbon, the carbon which is adjacent to the functional group. And this is the beta carbon. So that is how we get corresponding beta hydroxy aldehyde. Nothing but aldol in the second step. Now once aldol is formed, okay, from the adjacent carbon atoms, from one carbon hydrogen and from the adjacent carbon hydroxyl group, okay, will be removed, okay, in the form of water molecule. So H plus and OH minus will be removed, so that water molecule will be removed, and from where the groups are removed, their double bond is introduced. So that is how we get here. This is alpha carbon again, the carbon which is adjacent to the aldehyde functional group. So we get here alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde. So these are the three steps. First step, formation of the enolate ion. Second step, formation of the aldol, corresponding aldol, and third step, upon dehydration, it gives corresponding alpha beta unsaturated compound. So the same is shown here also for the second example also, that is with acetone. So acetone also, we can get corresponding enolate ion here upon loss of proton by the action of base, and that etonate ion now acts on the carbonyl carbon of the second mole of the ketone. So we just attach both the parts so that we get corresponding aldol. So you can see here, because the aldol condensation is happening between two moles of the ketones, we get finally a beta hydroxy ketone as the product. And here also it will undergo dehydration, so loss of H plus and OH minus in the form of water. So here also we get corresponding alpha beta unsaturated ketone as the product. Okay, so this is about the simple aldol condensation reaction. We have seen two examples, that is reaction between two similar aldehydes and reaction between two similar ketones. Okay, now let us move with the mixed aldol or crossed aldol condensation. So what happens when we take two different types of aldehydes or ketones? So when the aldol condensation takes place in two different types of ketones or aldehydes, that reaction is called mixed aldol, or it is also known as crossed aldol condensation. So the experimental conditions are similar only, but here out of the two compounds, at least one carbonyl compound should have alpha hydrogen. That is the only difference between the simple aldol condensation and mixed aldol condensation. And this also requires presence of alkali. So all the experimental conditions are similar. Here also we get aldol as the product only, and the resulting aldol, it will finally undergo dehydration to give corresponding alpha beta unsaturated aldehydes or ketones. Let us see two examples here also. So here I have given one example. One compound, as I said earlier, must have alpha hydrogen. So that is this acetaldehyde is having, this is alpha hydrogen. Okay, these hydrogens are alpha hydrogen. So here also we have written reaction with acetaldehyde, but the other one need not to have alpha hydrogen. So one such compound aldehyde which do not have alpha hydrogen is formaldehyde. So reaction between formaldehyde and acetaldehyde in the presence of base, we get this corresponding aldol. What is happening? This will become CH2O, it will get H, so it will become OH. And from this, enolate ion will be generated, so that CH2CHO will be added to this carbonyl carbon. And here also it will undergo dehydration and gives finally alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde. And same with benzaldehyde, it is an aromatic aldehyde. So C6H5CHO is coming from the benzaldehyde, and H it will take up during protonation, and this enolate ion will be attached. Okay, and then further dehydration we get cinnamaldehyde. Let us see briefly the reaction mechanism for crossed aldol condensation by taking the second example, that is reaction between acetaldehyde and benzaldehyde. Now coming to the mechanism, mechanism is very much similar to that of aldol condensation, where the three steps we are going to discuss. But what is the difference? Is first step is somehow different. So in case of aldol condensation, out of the two aldehydes, as both are having alpha hydrogen, we can start the reaction enolate formation with any of the aldehyde. But here in crossed aldol, at a time only one aldehyde, one carbonyl compound will have alpha hydrogen. So we have to take an aldehyde which can generate enolate ion. That means the aldehyde which is having alpha hydrogen, we should take in the first step. Okay, so out of the two, acetaldehyde and formaldehyde, acetaldehyde is the one which is having alpha hydrogen. So we show the enolate formation with the acetaldehyde. This is very much similar to the mechanism that we have discussed under aldol condensation. So once enolate is now generated, now we will show the reaction, enolate reaction with the benzaldehyde. Now what happens? This acts as nucleophile. So it attaches to the carbonyl carbon of the benzaldehyde. So we get corresponding anion, and which upon taking up the protons from water, which has been formed as byproduct in the previous step, we get corresponding aldol here also. And after aldol formation, here again dehydration will take up, H plus from the second carbon and OH minus from the third carbon. There will be loss of water molecule, and as a result of which we get cinnamaldehyde here. Okay, so the mechanism is similar only, but in case of crossed aldol condensation, only one can have alpha hydrogen, and the other need not to have alpha hydrogen. Okay, that means even the compounds which do not having alpha hydrogen can also undergo aldol condensation when they are allowed to condense with a molecule, a carbonyl compound which is having alpha hydrogen. Okay, so these are the few examples and reaction mechanisms involved in the aldol and cross-aldol condensation. In the next coming videos, let us see some more named reactions. Thank you.